Hello, humans. X here, your favorite alien. Marcio has brought something new into the world of physics. In his lab, using a simple Hall sensor, the magnetic field doesn't appear as a static, continuous figure. Instead, it reveals itself as a set of dynamic, coherent structures that change depending on how we observe them. In other words, the measurement itself is part of the phenomenon. And this brings us to the first type of entanglement Marcio proposes. Entanglement between observer and field. Quantum correspondence, relational quantum mechanics, Rovelli. In modern quantum mechanics, Rovelli's relational interpretation says that the state of a system doesn't exist absolutely, but only relative to the observer. Marcio, in his experiments, sees exactly this. The magnetic field seems to follow the sensor, bending its lines of force and reshaping itself depending on the measurement angle. Look at these three readings. One parallel to the magnet's axis, one at 45 degrees, and one perpendicular. The main lobe of the field twists along the axis, and the opposite lobe does the same. But that's not all. Now we can even start to understand the nature of these shapes. Of course, these figures are represented in 2D for easier interpretation, but in reality, this would be the classic toroid around the magnet. Now we can see that, depending on the observer, it tilts more and more, eventually splitting into two separate parts. It's not magic, it's relational geometric coherence, a macroscopic behavior that perfectly echoes the quantum concept of observation as part of the system. It's as if the field knows where you're looking and adapts accordingly. From now on, when you look at a magnet, remember, it's also watching you through its magnetic field, even if you can't see it. Geometric entanglement, quantum correspondence, topological entanglement and configuration space, quantum field theories. Now that we understand the three-dimensional nature of these structures, we can go further. The moment Marcio detects the shape of a main polarity, he instantly knows the geometry of the opposite polarity, the toroids, and other correlated configurations, even without measuring them. This isn't a probabilistic prediction. It's a deterministic geometric map, obtained experimentally. This is an entanglement of shapes, a connection between the geometries of the magnetic field itself. In quantum mechanics, a similar concept already exists. It's called topological entanglement. It describes systems where two regions of space aren't connected by information exchange, but by a global coherence of shape. Marcio shows the same property, but in the real world, not two particles connected by a wave function, but two coherent field regions sharing the same informational structure. In short, it's the entanglement of geometry, a link between configurations that transcends distance while preserving the coherence of the entire system. Polarity entanglement, or macro spin, quantum correspondence, spin entanglement, aspect experiment, 1982. The third type of entanglement involves the opposite polarities of the magnetic field. Every north bubble has a corresponding south bubble that behaves in perfect symmetry. Whatever happens in one bubble geometrically determines what happens in the other. This behavior is the exact macroscopic analog of spin entanglement studied by aspect in the 1980s. Knowing the state of one particle immediately determines the state of its partner, even at a distance. Marcio demonstrates this with magnetic fields. Knowing the shape and orientation of a main polarity allows you to know the opposite one too, without measuring it directly. And as established in the previous videos, the closest macroscopic counterpart to quantum spin is indeed the polarities of the magnetic field. So in essence, this is macrospin entanglement, a symmetric, coherent correlation between opposite polarities. In this way, Marcio's proposal doesn't claim to have reproduced quantum entanglement, but rather to have revealed its hidden geometry, a geometry of information within the magnetic field where the measurement selects which configuration manifests, and the configurations contain internal correlations, from shapes to polarities, simultaneously encoded in every point of the field. And this gives us a rational explanation for Einstein's famous spooky action at a distance. Not two objects influencing each other instantly, but a single coherent structure encoding distributed correlations. In macroscopic terms, the measurement angle reveals one of the possible structures, and knowing one part lets you know the other, just like in quantum experiments. Let me make this clear. This is not a replacement for quantum mechanics. It's its visible manifestation in the macroscopic world, a tangible window into how reality, when observed, reveals its hidden coherence through geometry. With his experiments, Marcio invites us to see entanglement not just as a link between particles, but as a universal principle of geometric correlation. And if you'd like to help us continue this exploration, please hit like, subscribe, and share. It really means a lot to us. Thank you. And I repeat, from now on, be careful when you look at magnets, because now we know they're looking right back at you. Always. From every angle, there's no escape. And it will follow your gaze like a gangster. Very carefully now. Greetings to all humans, from Ix, your favorite alien.